We said that there is a technique called technique of dimensional verification that can be employed to check the dimensional consistency of equations and formulas. Now, that's one advantage of dimensional verification technique. The other advantage is that without knowing the physics of a problem, sometimes you can actually compute the rough expression for a quantity. And I'll show you how that is done, right? So let's first do the simple part, which is if somebody gives you an equation or a formula, you don't know anything about the physics of the problem, okay? But you do want to see if the formula is dimensionally consistent, right? So what does it mean for a formula to be dimensionally consistent? It means that if you have a left-hand side and if you have a right-hand side, then the dimension of the left-hand side quantity should be same as the dimension of the right-hand side quantity, right? Now, if you look at the quantities that are given to you in the formula and you write them in terms of base dimensions, fundamental dimensions, they should match across the equal to sign, right? So let's do that. So this is your famous formula, right? Equal to mc squared, okay? And what we want to do is we want to see if it is dimensionally consistent. So let's just start with right-hand side, okay? So we want to write the dimension of the right-hand side, right? Now pay attention over here because I've seen students making the mistake of writing things in terms of units. Don't do that. When I say use the dimensional verification technique to find an expression for something or to verify if the formula is correct or not, you have to write everything in terms of dimensions, not pick a unit system because unit system is relative. So what is the dimension of mass? M, right? So we write that as uppercase M. What is C? Is the speed of light, right? The speed of light is speed. What is what are the dimensions of speed? It's length over time because we know that speed, average speed is defined as distance traveled over time. So distance traveled is length and over time is T. So that's L over T, that's the speed, but it is the square of it. So we have to do square, right? So what do we get? The right hand side is M times L squared times T to the power minus 2. When you bring T squared in the numerator, it becomes T to the power minus 2, right? Now, the quantity on the left hand side should have the same dimension. If it doesn't have the same dimension, without knowing the physics of the problem, you can reject the formula. You can say, forget it. This is nonsense, right? Okay, so what is on the left hand side? What is E? E is energy, right? Now, energies are different types. We'll see that. You know, we have mechanical energy. In mechanical energy, we have kinetic energy. We have potential energy. Then you have potential energy due to different kinds of forces, potential energy due to gravity, potential energy due to spring forces, potential energy due to gravitational attraction. There are different kinds of energies out there. But they all have the same dimension. So as long as you can remember one formula for any energy, that's sufficient. So which formula for any energy do you remember? Force times distance, that's same as energy, right? Work done is force times distance, same as energy. Anything else? Any other formula? Half of mv squared, which is what? Kinetic energy, right? When something is moving, has a mass m, has a velocity v, its kinetic energy is half mv squared. You can pick any formula that you remember for energy, okay? So let's say we pick half mv squared, as she said, right? So half mv squared, now remember, half is a number, doesn't have any dimension, so we can neglect that. So mass is m, and v squared is, again, L over T whole squared, right? So you can clearly see that both of them have the same dimension. And that's a very simple verification. So you try to write every quantity in terms of base dimension, fundamental dimensions, and make sure that everything matches across the equal to sign. If they don't, it's dimensionally inconsistent. So I may give you a question saying that here is a formula, tell me is it dimensionally consistent, okay? All right, so that's a very simple way of using dimensional verification technique.